This'll be the one. This'll be the one we refer back to if the Cards miss the postseason by a game. This was brutal, and that's saying something, considering it was the Cardinals' 22nd loss after leading by multiple runs, per ESPN Stats Info, the most in baseball. And for Boston fans, this must have felt like the Super Bowl comeback against Atlanta all over again. Boston 5, St. Louis 4, on Wednesday night at Fenway Park, never once did a Red Sox batter come to the plate with a lead, and the Red Sox beat the Cardinals. The Cards make one little mad dash in 46, and ruin one little impossible dream in 67, and now the Red Sox seem to seek vengeance in perpetuity. Now, it's only fair to point out that the Cards did make some mistakes in the game. Matt Carpenter did the impossible HDINT score from third on a single to center. Yes, the ball might have been caught, so I understand why Carp hesitated, but the play at the plate WASNT even a play, per se. He was so out. But the Cards had the lead, 42, entering the ninth inning. And lost. Now, I generally hate whining about the umpires. It can be a little petty. Sometimes, a quick trigger reaction to other frustrations. But this was Game 6 Denkinger bad, a lot of barking going on almost all game long with the strike zone, St. Louis manager Mike Matheny told reporters. A lot of frustration at the end, umpire Chris Seigel somehow seemed to get worse as the game went on. A couple of his strike calls were not only high, but also outside. It was like it was Leslie Nielsen in the Naked Gun back there. Imagine what Ian Kinsler would have had to say about this umpire. Yes, yes, he made bad calls that went against the Sox, too. But Siegel, who was in the news a month ago for valiantly surviving a backswing to the head, will be in the news Thursday for just a preposterous performance behind the plate. Mix in Trevor Rosenthal's issues and one of the weirder moments of the season, and this was a cockamamie cocktail for Cards fans to swallow. Rosenthal came in for the save, and right away, this looked like last year's version of the guy, something didn't look right, Matheny said. You see the 91 on the fastball, he's been a little tight, you saw what happened next, the homer, the walk, the call to the pen. Zach Duke, John Brebbia, and then Casey Stengel's old line was, every day in baseball you see something you never saw before. But even the things you've never seen are at least conceivable. Here was an umpire, that same umpire, seemingly calling time out on his own. Not the batter, and not the pitcher Brebbia, who fortunately didn't tear his elbow in mid-pitch, he shortened his throw home upon seeing time called. It was seemingly Siegel. Yadier Molina knew it, erupting on the ump, and rightfully so. And Matheny, a former catcher, stepped in to scream, as Fox Sports Midwest microphone caught, it's not your show, man. 10 questions Hochman on Cardinals concerns. Meanwhile, in Chicago, Anthony Rizzo hit a grand slam and St. Louis succumbed to watching the in-game highlight of the Cubs relievers dancing in the bullpen. I suppose the saving grace of the night was the Cubs winning on a wild pitch, so there wouldn't be any more bullpen dancing to endure. Oh, Brewers won, too. For the Birds, it was. Just one game, but it could be the one game. Now four on the road, including the weird one in the minor league stadium on Sunday. We'll learn a lot about the Cardinals after an unhappy flight to Pittsburgh. Can this team find a way to not let Wednesday's loss affect Thursday and Friday and so on? Also, what do you do if Rosenthal is seriously injured? Tyler Lyons should at least get some consideration to be the fill-in closer. He's got some filthy stuff and has only allowed a lone hit in his past 10 appearances. As for the Cardinals faithful, early on Wednesday night, many were treated to the tweeted video of the game's first pitch. It went viral, a first pitch thrown wild, actually kind of similar to Brebbia's non-pitch. The ball floated way to the catcher's left, hitting cameraman Tony Capobianco right in the baked beans. 9 innings later, that's how St. Louisans felt.